I have Avorio Rosas, and then I have Sandra Sanchez afterwards.
Buenas noches, mi nombre es Evodio Rosas. Yo vivo en el apartamento 3425 de Gates Place. Nuestro Orlando.
Okay, I'm just gonna ask that we respect the person who has waited and to speak, so that we can all hear the speaker. Thank you.
¿Puede repetirse?
Sí, mi nombre es Evodio Rosas, vivo en el 3425 de Gates Place. Landon es Morgan Group. Ellos nos hicieron el reparo de los baños y las cocinas. Nunca nos dijeron al principio que nos iban a aumentar. Cuando nos llegó el aumento, nos llegó un aumento de 325 para mi apartamento. Yo pagaba 1,443, ahora tengo que pagar 1,768. Es un aumento muy grande. Yo tengo dos muchachos en la universidad, ¿ve? Tengo muchos gastos. Tengo una familia que mantener. Ahora tengo que cortar.
Good evening. My name is Idolia Roses. I live on 3425 Gates Place. My landlord is Morgan Group, and when they came to fix my bathroom and my kitchen, they didn't give me any notice that there was going to be any rent increase. We found out after we got the monthly bill, and we noticed that there was an increase of $325. My rent used to be $1,443, and now it's $1,768. I have two kids in college, and I cannot afford it.
Sí, y aparte de eso, ellos han hecho un trabajo muy malo. Ellos, ¿verdad? Ellos nos trataron como ellos quisieron cuando hicieron los reparos. ¿Ve? Ellos escogieron el material que ellos quisieron. Nuestros baños nos hicieron más pequeños por avanzar. Nuestras cocinas las hicieron más pequeñas por avanzar.
All the work that was done in the apartments was of bad quality. They used bad materials. They treated us bad as they were when they were working in the apartments. They also made the bathrooms and the kitchen smaller.
Entonces yo no creo que ese aumento valga. ¿Verdad? Porque nosotros, no, ese building no es nuestro. Ellos quieren que lo paguemos en 9 años. En 9 años. ¿Y qué va a pasar después? ¿Nos van a bajar el aumento? No creo. ¿Usted cree que nos van a bajar? ¿Verdad que no? Ese aumento es para siempre. Para siempre. Gracias.
We don't think that an increase is fair here. The landlord wants to pay this building off in 9 years, and we're helping him to pay it off, and we're not getting a penny back.
Señor.
Mr. Rosas.
Una cuestión. Usted dijo que el casero hizo un reparo, que es diferente que un ese improvement, you know, que
fue una renovación.
Él llegó a reparar algo, entonces te puso como reparar.
No, ellos hicieron renovación, nos renovaron.
Ok, so usted supo que era una renovación, que no era reparo.
Sí, exactamente, okay. Pero cuando llegamos con el aumento, ¿verdad? Nosotros
no sabían que iba a aumentar la renta.
Sí, y ellos al principio nos mandaron una carta diciendo que no nos iban a aumentar. Uh-huh. Y eso nosotros no la creímos. Uh-huh. Entonces cuando nos mandaron la otra carta, Yo peleé con la esposa mía. Digo, no, pero si ya nos dijeron una carta. Okay. ¿Verdad? Okay. Una carta que nos mandaron diciendo que no hay aumento. Okay. Después llega que hay aumento.
Okay. I just asked him more or less that if he thought it was a repair or he knew it was an improvement. But he knew it was an improvement, but the fact was that he was told that there wasn't going to be a cost. Just as a curiosity point, because I'm very curious about this. How many people in the last 2 years have had, and please be honest, how many people have had an MCI on their apartment in the last 2 years? Thank you. Thank you very much.
Gracias. I have Sandra Sanchez and I have Nova Lucero coming on deck.
Sí, buenas noches.
Yeah, I'm sorry. One more question.
Since we are asking questions, how many people in this room think that the rent should go up? Exactly.
Ms. Sanchez?
Sí, buenas noches. Y
buenas noches.
Yo vengo del 3425 de Games Place. Mi nombre es Sandra Sanchez. Y tengo viviendo ya casi 14 años. Y todo empezó, primero estábamos viviendo bien. No tenía problemas con el baño, ni la cocina, ni nada de eso. Todo empezó después de las renovaciones que hicieron. Entonces me empezó a fallar todo lo que fue la cocina, el baño. Ahorita tengo problemas con electricidad. Y sigo teniendo problemas. Sí.
Good evening. My name is Sandra Sanchez. I live on 3425 Gates Place. I've been there for 14 years. At the beginning, we had no issues. We were very happy there. But after the renovations, everything's starting to fail in the kitchen and the bathroom.
Y me aumentaron mucho la renta también. Yo iba a pagar 1,300 y con el aumento que me pusieron son 1,600, 300 más que tengo que pagar. Y yo vivo sola con 4 hijos y tengo que trabajar para pagar toda esa renta y el Lando no le importa. Solamente dice que tenemos que pagar el aumento porque si no me van a mandar a corte o me van a desalojar de mi apartamento.
I used to pay $1,300 and now I have to pay $1,600. I live alone with 4 children and the landlord doesn't care about our situation. He just tells me if I don't pay the rent, they're going to kick us out. Or take us to court.
Sí, y por eso yo estoy preocupada porque pues yo no estoy dispuesta a pagar el aumento porque no tengo que pagarlo porque no es mi apartamento. Y además las renovaciones que hicieron son de mala calidad. Todo, porque se descompone a cada rato las cosas. Ya no sabe, ahora van a ir esta semana a reparar la electricidad porque estallaron los focos o como se dice, bombillos, ¿verdad?
I'm really worried about this situation because I cannot afford it and I feel like I shouldn't be paying this amount because the apartment is not even mine. All the renovations were bad quality and I'm having electricity problems. They're going to come and fix them this week. All the bulbs are breaking.
Eso es todo. Gracias.
Thank you very much.
Gracias. I have Nova Lucero, and then I have George Diaz. Nova Lucero?
Escucha, estamos en la lucha. RGB, escucha, estamos en la lucha. RGB, escucha, estamos en la lucha.
Nova Lucero?
Yeah, sí, yo estoy aquí. I'm here. Come on, siéntate. I'm with the Northwest Bronx. I've been a Bronx resident for over 15 years. I just want to first remind everybody, especially the new public members, that the Rent Guidelines Board was created because of tenants. For tenants, okay? Who knew that already? Did the public members do that? Did you guys know that? This space was created for tenants because the landlords have always abused tenants. I want to start with everybody raise your hand if the following applies to you, okay? Because I need a reminder of how many people have been abused or harassed or bullied by their landlord or super or somebody from management. Raise your hand. Keep your hand raised if you're able to, if you've been sent to housing court for no reason at all. If you've been told that you haven't paid the rent when you have. If you've ever been evicted or been homeless in the street or in a shelter. If you've ever had to move in with family or with friends for some time because you haven't had the money to stay in your apartment or because you've been evicted. Thank you. There are very few mechanisms that tenants have to actually stay in their homes without harassment or without rent increases. You can send your landlord to court for repairs, but not only are they given multiple chances to not do repairs, there is no enforcement of fines when they are found to not do repairs. You can file for a rent overcharge complaint, but it can take years for a decision to be made. In the meantime, you as a tenant, we are harassed, we are offered a buyout, we are sent to housing court. Almost all MCIs are approved, and when you do challenge them, the landlords are given multiple opportunities, like Allison already shared, to show proof that they didn't lie the first time, and the second time, and the third time, or that they didn't do construction as harassment during that time. Public members, you have an opportunity here to go back to the real purpose of the Rent Guidelines Board. It is not for the landlords. It's not for the five landlords that de Blasio is clearly like more worried about of making money. The majority of New York City are renters. The majority of us are rent-regulated tenants.
Thank you.
So this Rent Guidelines Board is for us. In order to make an impact on our city and make sure that we're not all pushed out, you need to make sure that we have a rent freeze this year or a rent rollback. This is for us as tenants, because what's best for us is what's best for the entire New York City.
Thank you.
Every year that tenants are evicted or harassed or bullied, we deserve a rent freeze. So raise your hand up if you were bullied or evicted or harassed or got an MCI or an IAI, or they were sending you to court for no reason. We deserve a rent freeze. Thank you.
So I have George Diaz next, but I just want to make a reminder that we have 8 minutes for sign up in the lobby. So if you have not yet signed up but would like to speak, please go up to the lobby and sign in the next 8 minutes. Mr. Diaz? And then after Mr. Diaz, I have Fabian Ramos.
All right. Good evening. Now, we're talking about rent increases. And I say we should have rent freezes. And more specifically, I say, why should landlords get rent increases? Thinking about what's going on, how many people over here are talking about being harassed by their landlords? How many people over here have faced a situation facing eviction, like I did when I was a kid? You know, my mother going to housing court, my mother to home. My friend Velvet was up there, spoke passionately about her situation, and you see that she has a master's degree, she's incredibly intelligent, you see that, and she's facing situations. Because now, what the landlords do is they target and take advantage of primarily women of color, women with children, and women who are disabled, and people who are disabled in general. So why should they get deserve to get a rent increase when they harass people? And the thing is, we talk about going to housing court, maybe sometimes you go to civil court. What actually we start talking about is taking landlords to criminal court when they're doing things about, when they're doing harassment, sexual harassment, and the conditions that they're leaving tenants in with black mold, bug and rodent infestations. What this is doing is you're hurt, their people are suffering their health, their mental well-being. This is like a form of violence against them, against tenants. This is why this should be actually looked at as criminal offenses. And that's why I want to thank Velvet, because we talked passionately about this. And as far as the actual rent increases, what are landlords doing? They're going to get a rent increase. When a new tenant comes in, they might do some minor adjustments, improvements inside the apartment or the building itself, and then they charge the tenants for this. And the thing is, let's say it costs $1,200 the repairs, if they actually even did the repair in the first place. But they're adding that to the rents, continuing over and over and over again. So even after that amount has been paid off, it still continues going. Then they get a tax break from the state. So they're triple dipping.
Thank you.
Why do they deserve a rent increase?
Thank you.
And I'm gonna say, my name is George Diaz, and I'm out here because I am running for New York State Assembly in the North Bronx, and I'm gonna talk about the things that my opponent and that many of our elected officials are too afraid to talk about. And many because they are taking money from landlords and developers.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I have Fabian Ramos, and then I have Ramona Monegro.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Fabian Ramos. I reside at 1530 Sheridan Avenue in the Bronx. I've been there for 17 years. I would like to let everyone know and stuff, Park Ash is our landlord. And of course, we've always had immense, huge issues with Vid Park Ash. The rent board, I know that y'all there to do a job. I can see some of y'all already over it. Others look like y'all actually listening and stuff, but we can no longer afford any more increases. You can only be a dog down but so much, you know? We need help, you know? Yes. You're actually helping our landlords push us out of our homes. We have no help or programs to assist us. Section 8 is closed. Screen and Dreer only freeze new lease increases for seniors and the disabled, leaving them to pay most of their rent. And that's from the time that they actually applied. I actually know several people who are disabled and that are seniors that didn't even know those programs existed. But of course, when they apply, that's when it begins from that moment on. Also, HRA only provides a one-shot deal to citizens who qualify and to avoid, you know, their eviction. Lots of times they have to pay that money back. There is no programs to help the poor and lower middle class citizens. We work 2 to 3 jobs, meanwhile trying to raise a family, and may I remind you, the next generation of New Yorkers. In case you have not noticed, food, clothing, and utilities have all gone up and salaries have been kept down. We need help. Please note that landlords have gotten money from Albany, the city of New York, and also given landlords big tax breaks and additional funds to assist landlords maintaining their buildings. Most pocket the money and do little to no repairs. Lots of them are the kings of plaster and paint because everything is cover up, you know. HPD inspectors come in.
Thank you.
They come in, they look, they approve everything, they say everything is fine when it is not fine. The conditions that we're living in are deplorable and we need help. We need someone to stand up for us.
Thank you. Thank you. I have Ramona Monegro and then I have Fitzroy Christian.
Registration closes in 1 minute.
Okay. And registration is closing in 1 minute, so if you have not signed up, you should do so now. I'm sorry, before you speak, Ms. Monegro, could the translator just say that if you want to sign up, you should do it now to speak.
Solo para recordarles que solo tienen un par de minutos para registrarse porque el corte llega hasta las 8.
Gracias. Sorry, Ms. Monegro.
Buenas noches.
Buenas
noches. Mi nombre es Ramona Monegro. Resido en el 215 de la 164, el Bronx, New York, claro está, 10456. Quiero hablarle de la renta estabilizada y preferencial, que es la renta que está en el building donde yo vivo. Algunos tienen renta estabilizada y otros tienen renta preferencial, como es el caso mío. Monegro.
Good evening, my name is Ramona Monegro. I live on 1215 164th Street. I want to talk to you about the stabilized rent and also the preferential rent that some of the people in my building get.
Nuestro edificio ahora tiene un nuevo dueño. A todo el que le ha tocado renovar el lease, le ha aumentado la renta hasta de $500 y $600 a su renta actual, que no es fácil recibir esta noticia cuando usted recibe un lease repentinamente, una renovación de un lease, y que le llegue un lease de $500 y $600 de aumento a una familia pobre que tiene un bajo ingreso. No es fácil esta situación.
We just got a new landlord, and some people got a new increase of almost between $500 and $600. This is really hard news for some people. Most of these families are poor and have low income.
Tuvimos una reunión con este casero y nos dijo que esto está dentro de lo legal, que él podía hacer esto.
We had a meeting with the landlord, and he told us that this was within the law and that he had the right to make the increase.
Nos parece que es una injusticia que cuando nos toque renovar un lease no llegue un aumento tan alto repentinamente como lo está pasando en nuestro edificio.
We think that is unfair that when we need to renew our lease we get such a huge increase.
Esto afecta grandemente a nuestros inquilinos porque el ingreso familiar solo será para pagar renta por lo que veo. Si apenas alcanza para pagar la renta, si es que alcanza el ingreso de la casa. Además, perdón, si no hay un congelamiento de la renta, pasaremos hambre, porque si aplicamos para food stamps, si nuestro ingreso pasa de unos dolaritos, ya no calificamos por estas, para estas estampillas de comida.
Thank you.
This affects the tenants in my building. It seems like all our income is going to go to paying the rent. If we don't get the freezing in the rent, we're going to be hungry because we cannot even apply for food stamps, because if we get any increase in our income, then we cannot apply for food stamps.
Thank you. Our next speaker.
Oh.
All right.
Esperamos que sean justos al tomar esta decisión de aumentar la renta. Queremos que piensen que somos comunidad de gente pobres, y que si no escuchan nuestros testimonios y reclamaciones, nos enfermaremos de angustia y de depresión porque no sabríamos qué hacer. Por favor, queremos congelación, no más aumento de renta. Por favor.
We want you to hear us, please, and to be fair when you make your decision. We're a community of poor people. We're going to get depressed and we're going to get anxiety because we will not know how to deal with this situation.
We have a council member, Vanessa Gibson, who I would ask to come to the microphone. She's not in the room. Oh, all right, when she comes. I have Fitzroy Christian, and then I have Ramon Catala afterwards.
Just before you start the clock, Ms. Goodridge had asked a question a little bit earlier about scree or dree. No, this is not part of my testimony. I'm just trying to help her explain it to you. When a senior citizen gets scree or a disabled person gets dree, it freezes their rent. It does not reverse their rent. It does not reduce it. So that when they are already paying 40, 50, 60, 70% of their rent, or sorry, their income in rent, they're still going to continue paying that. It is not going to change their condition. They're still going to be facing eviction. So scree or dree do not work for everybody. You have to catch it very early where it can work. But when you're already paying almost all of your income in rent, getting scree or dree is not a savior. It just protects you from further increases, right? I just needed to add that. Now I will give my testimony. Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Fitzroy Christian. I've been living in the Bronx for 47 years, and I'm a CASA leader. You've heard a whole lot, the horrors that a lot of tenants in the Bronx and New York City go through, so I'm not going to repeat it. What I want to do is to offer you a few bits of information so that you could have that to digest along with the stories you've been hearing from the tenants. A new report by the Coalition for the Homeless, quoted in Curb in April, just a couple of months ago, noted that the number of people staying in shelters each night is big enough to be New York's ninth largest city. Those are just the homeless. And that figure is expected to be increased by over 5,000 people by 2022, which is 7,500 more than the Blasio administration targeted or projected when he began developing a plan to tackle the issue in 2017. So we are getting more homeless people than less. And that is because the rent guidelines board historically have been taken from the poor tenants and given it to rich landlords, which caused more and more evictions. The former city council speaker, and who is now the CEO of the largest shelter for families, said that the housing subsidy we have for those who get subsidies is in functionality the equivalent of no subsidy at all. She said that the 1557, which is the maximum monthly rent eligible for the program for a family of four, is not sufficient in a city where the medium asking rent was $2,650.
Thank you.
I'm not finished. The U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development's annual homelessness assessment report for 2018 said that 552,830 homeless people across the country exist. New York has 78,000, and New York City alone has 14% of the nation's homelessness. That is because the Rent Guidelines Board keeps increasing the rents for people who cannot afford it.
Thank you.
The Coalition for the Homeless report that the number of homeless people in New York has increased 40% since 2010. In April 2019, the homeless population included 14,826 homeless families, and that included 21,709 homeless children. They're sleeping each night in the city's municipal shelter system, and those kids have to leave the shelter to go to school every day.
Thank you.
And that is not right. I'm almost finished. Any increase at all, will only add to these numbers, and the Rent Guideline Board will be complicit in the increased misery of families that are being displaced and being evicted and are living in shelters. That is what you would do, and that is going to be your burden if you give another rent increase. This is why what we should be seeing happening and what we deserve here in New York City is a rent rollback for both 1 and 2 year leases. But at the very least, we deserve and we are demanding a rent freeze. Landlords are doing very well while most of the tenants are catching hell. You, the board, have an obligation, a duty, and a mandate to correct the housing and social injustice. Do your due diligence and give us a rent rollback, or at least give us a rent freeze. Thank you.
So, I just wanna let everyone know we have over 30 speakers left. So, for those who are worried about getting to work tomorrow morning or family obligations, sticking to the 2 minutes will help everyone.
Vanessa's here.
I understand that council member Vanessa Gibson is here. I would invite her to the microphone. I'm sorry.
Un segundo que llegó una persona que va a testificar antes de que tú.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you so much. My deepest apologies for my late arrival. It's budget time. I am Councilmember Vanessa Gibson. I represent District 16 in the great borough of the Bronx. And I thank you to the members, to the chair, and the Rent Guidelines Board members. Thank you for hosting us this evening. There was a time years ago when we did not have the opportunity to have a Bronx hearing. So I am thankful every year that RGB recognizes the importance of including the voices of the Bronx. You have sat here for hours since this evening, and you've heard a lot of testimony from many of the tenants throughout the borough. And what I want all of you to understand, the testimonies and the stories that you are hearing come from a place of personal experience. There are too many households in the city of New York, and particularly in the Bronx, who are rent burdened. Many tenants and families pay more than 30% of their income towards rent. Too many families have to literally choose between medication, food, and paying the rent. And over the years, RGB has recognized that, and I want to applaud you for the past approval of a rent freeze, because tenants in the city, and in particular in Bronx County, need and deserve that. If anything, they need and deserve a rent rollback, but I understand, and also want to make mention that a rent freeze should remain on the table. I am proud to serve as a member of the City Council. I am proud to be one of the authors of the Universal Right to Counsel, because far too many tenants face eviction proceedings every single year in this borough, and they needed free attorneys just so that they can be protected and remain in their homes. The City Council has passed a number of legislative items that are reflective of our priorities, including the Certificate of No Harassment. Why did we do that? Because too many tenants are harassed by unscrupulous landlords. And we're not saying all landlords are bad, but we want to recognize that this is a system where every tenant should be afforded the opportunity to live in affordable and quality housing. We say this all the time, but we absolutely mean it. Access to affordable and quality housing is a fundamental right. It is a part of our democracy, it is a part of our values, and truthfully, what we deserve in the Bronx. And as the RGB deliberates and as you analyze and review all of the testimony that you have heard this evening and you will continue to hear, I want you to put yourself in the place of a tenant that may be undocumented, a tenant that may be living in an apartment that is too small, a tenant that may be doubled up with another family, a tenant that experiences no heat and no hot water every day, a tenant that experiences brown water every day, a tenant that leaves their apartment to discover that the elevator is not working and they have to walk up and down the stairs, a tenant that has a disability, a tenant that has a child, a tenant that wants to go food shopping and simply is not afforded the necessities that we're talking about. I have been a long-time advocate for tenants. The tenants that you see here all live in this district, and they deserve better than what they have been given. And so this is an opportunity for the RGB to not only show that you recognize and hear the concerns, the complaints, the cries and the pleas of all of the tenants in this county, but you actually can do something about it. We as a city have to send a resounding message to those landlords that think it's okay to take advantage of tenants. It is not acceptable. We know that landlords have to provide a service. And we know that there are benefits that landlords are afforded, and we understand that. But we have a problem when landlords take advantage of tenants. And that happens far too often, ladies and gentlemen. And so I stand here on behalf of so many of my residents and families that come to our office, that stop me in the street, that see me in church, in the supermarket as I walk down the street, and they tell me a story. They have a testimony. And so tonight you've just heard a snippet of some of the issues that we are facing. We also recognize that in this work, we need our partners in Albany to make sure that they pass universal rent control. That is important. So while our state legislators need to do their work, so does the RGB. And the City Council has not only been a partner with so many of our advocacy groups and our tenants, because tenants are becoming advocates every day out of personal experience. They are the voices for the voiceless and for the tenants that don't think their issues are important enough to discuss. And so while we sit here and represent the larger community of the Bronx, we just want to let you know that there is an overflow of consistency, of advocacy, fighting for a rent roll back. So do not be discouraged by the fact that many people have left. Our issues, our priorities remain the same. I have provided written testimony for each of you. I have extra copies should you need, but I honestly didn't even read my testimony, members, because this is something that I live with and deal with every single day. I don't need written testimony to speak from the heart about what a rollback means to the constituents of this borough. And so I thank you for being here. I thank you for hearing the concerns. And I really hope that at the end of the day, we continue to stand firm in what we fundamentally believe is the right to affordable and quality housing. The time is now. We don't have time to wait. There are too many families living in shelters that need access to affordable housing. And the work we're doing is to keep families out of the shelter system, right? And so I thank you for your time. I thank every tenant, every organizer, every advocacy group. We do this because we have to make a difference. We can't just talk about it, but we have to be about it. And so tonight is an opportunity to hear from all of the tenants, and as their council member, we appeal to you, hear us and help us to make a difference and show this city and show unscrupulous landlords that we mean business. Roll back, rent freeze, do what is needed to make sure we protect the fabric of our communities, and that is our homes. Thank you so much, RGB. I look forward to working with you, and I thank you all for being here tonight.
Thank you, Councilmember Gibson. I have Ramon Catala, and then I have Estela Santos.
She really hates me.
Five men, all right? Okay. Don't rush me. Okay. Yo vivo en el 1685 de Topen Avenue por mucho tiempo y el casero que tenemos ahora se llama, ustedes saben quién es, Ken Wave de Cash. Ken Wave de Cash.
I live on 1885 Topen Wave and my landlord is Kane Wave.
De Cash.
De Cash.
Sí, ellos saben quién es él. Sí. Este es el hombre más malo que hay en el planeta como landlord. Después que lo llevé a la corte y le gané el caso, le abrió el caso de nuevo el comisionado de DCR, donde se registra la gente, le abrió el caso de nuevo al casero.
He's the meanest person in the whole world. I went to court with him and I won the case, and then the commissioner reopened the case.
Después me llevó a la Corte Suprema, donde también yo tuve otra victoria.
Then we went to the Supreme Court where I also won the case.
La abogada que tengo, que casa fue que nos la consiguió, ella ahora está en duda, no sabe qué hacer porque hemos tenido victorias y seguimos con los mismos problemas.
I have a great lawyer that Casa found for me, and we have two victories, and we have worked with her since then.
Yo tengo un artículo aquí que viene de Albany, donde la mayoría son los demócratas, y ahora quieren sacar a las manzanas podridas que hay en Albany.
I have an article here from Albany where the majority are Democrats, and they want to take all the bad apples from the system.
Ellos son los que permiten a los caseros recitar que registren rentas demasiado altas para después desalojado de sus apartamentos.
They're the ones who led landlords to raise the rents after they get the current tenants out.
Everything is here, loud and clear. Chairman Deboa, when we go back to Cooper Square, we want to see different numbers across the board. Remember, different numbers across the board, starting with zero rent increase. Zero rent increase. And thank you very much.
Thank you. I have Estela Santos, and then I have Ross Tiesha. Estela Santos? Is Estela here? Ross Tiesha, and then Hendrik Medrano.
Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.
Gracias por estar aquí, tomar su tiempo. Yo quiero preguntarle a ustedes si ustedes cobran el mínimo como cobramos nosotros los pobres. A lo mejor ustedes cobran más que nosotros.
He's saying, good evening. Thank you so much for hearing us. I want to know if you get the minimum wages we do.
Ustedes no quieren sacar. Ustedes nos representan a nosotros. Ustedes están aquí porque no nos están defendiendo. Están defendiendo a los landlords y a los ricos como ustedes.
You're not representing us, you're representing the rich people and the landlords.
A lo mejor me pregunto, ¿cuánto le están pagando los landlords a ustedes por subirnos la renta a nosotros?
I'm just wondering how much are you getting paid for raising the rents on us.
Yo un tiempo estuve en la calle, viví en Chester. Allí el que está ahí hay que levantarse a las 6 de la mañana, luego hay que estar a las 10 de la noche para no perder el lugar donde dormir. Hoy tengo un apartamento, gracias a la sesión 8, por las reparaciones que no hace mi landlord. Yo tengo un voucher aquí que me están botando mi apartamento porque el landlord no quiere reparar mi casa.
I used to live on the streets and I had to be up by 6 a.m. and then back on the shelter before 10 so I could get a spot. I also have a voucher here from the landlord who's like trying to kick me out of my apartment.
Cuando el Lando llegó a ese apartamento, yo estaba ahí y él no puede sacarme donde yo estaba por 15 años allí. El que llegó allí fue él, no fui yo.
When the landlord came to give me the notice, I was there and he wasn't able to kick me out because I was supposed to be there for 15 years.
Que esto no sea una audiencia más, sino una victoria para nosotros los pobres, que ustedes nos ayuden a nosotros. A lo mejor ustedes están en su casa, a lo mejor cobran bastante dinero. Muchos de nosotros no tenemos la oportunidad de tener un 401k. Ustedes lo tienen y en cualquier momento se pueden jubilar. Ustedes pueden ver los muchos ancianos que están aquí, todavía siguen trabajando. Ustedes en 3 años, 4 años se pueden jubilar cuando ustedes quieran.
We just don't want this to be another hearing. We want this to be a victory. I know you're at home and you can charge your great salaries and you have your 401k, but what's the
que muchos de ellos no se pueden jubilar.
As you can see, there's a lot of elder people here that cannot just stop working.
A lo mejor nos dan 2 minutos para hablar. Si ustedes no defendieran, no estuvieran perdiendo el tiempo aquí. Mientras nosotros estamos hablando y gritando por nuestros derechos, nadie nos da agua. Ustedes tienen café, jugo y agua sin hablar nada ahí sentado.
As we're here fighting for our rights, we don't get anything. You're there drinking water, drinking coffee without doing anything.
Y nosotros aquí parándonos a cada rato, yendo al baño o bebiendo algo en la fuente, agua que no está purificada. Gracias, buenas noches.
We have to go outside to the bathroom and we have to drink water from the fountain and you're just sitting there drinking your bottled water.
Una pregunta, ¿a usted le están dando el voucher de sección 8 porque las reparaciones del edificio no la han hecho?
Claro, y aparte tengo 9 meses sin gas y muchas cosas que están pasando allí, como dijo una de las compañeras aquí. De nuevo, 9 meses sin tener gas allí, el Ando no hace nada. Solamente algunos edificios le pusieron. Ni con Edison dice nada, ni el Ando tampoco dice nada.
So I just asked him why he has a Section 8 voucher and they're asking him to move, and it's because they're not making repairs. You can translate what he said.
He's saying that he's been 9 months without gas, and then Con Edison doesn't have an answer, the landlord doesn't have an answer.
Lo poco que yo gano no me alcanza a pagar la renta y comer afuera. Ya un lunch ahora mismo, una comida, una sola vez que yo compro, me sale a veces hasta $15. Y si lo compro por tres, ¿cuánto sería?
He's saying that he can barely afford the rent, and if he goes out for lunch, it's approximately $15, and then multiply that by three.
Por favor, a lo mejor, ayúdennos a nosotros para nosotros no tener que irnos de Nueva York. Ustedes están permitiendo que la ciudad de Nueva York se quede sin personas como nosotros. Ustedes lo están haciendo solamente para que queden ustedes los ricos, porque ustedes son parte de ellos también. Algunos que mueven la cabeza que sí, pero no están ayudando, porque ustedes son los que suben la renta. Y nosotros queremos que ustedes nos ayuden a nosotros, porque mientras usted puede estar con su familia en esta hora, por usted está haciendo a lo mejor mal su trabajo, están aquí con nosotros pidiendo el tiempo también. Gracias.
We need you to help us so we don't have to leave New York. You're only letting the rich people stay in New York. I know that we may be all here wasting our time because you're not doing your job.
I have Hendrik Medrano, and then
yo soy un dominicano que no es rico. Oíste, yo soy un dominicano que no es rico. Te lo aprecio tu testimonio, de verdad. Pero de verdad, yo vengo aquí a servir mi comunidad. Y tú lo que estás insultando a mí mientras yo estoy tratando de escucharte a ti.
Okay.
La verdad.
Usted.
Well, it's because, I felt like, frankly, I'm just like the gentleman, because I hear his accent. I'm a Dominican and he ain't rich. And he's accusing me of being rich. And I'm not. I'm here serving my community. And I just feel like, you know, he needs to understand that and respect it as well.
Okay. Yo no lo estoy insultando a ustedes. Yo me estoy defendiendo. Ustedes nos están ofendiendo a nosotros cada vez que nos suben la renta, que nos quieren votar de la ciudad de Nueva York. Tú no cobras $15 la hora. Yo sí la cobro. Ellos la cobran. ¿Tú puedes decir cuánto tú cobras la hora? ¿Cuánto es tu sueldo a diferente de nosotros que estamos pobres?
¿Y tú fuiste a la escuela mía para yo trabajar? Bueno, hablamos ahorita.
No, los pobres aquí también no tienen oportunidades, porque como dijo un señor por aquí, él tiene dos hijos que ir a la universidad y por pagar la renta puede ser que no lo pueda llevar. Tú lo puedes llevar lo tuyo porque tiene dinero. Perdóname si yo te vine a insultar.
And then I have Juanita Rodriguez.
Sí, pero él me está hablando.
¿Hendrik Medrano? Is Hendrik here?
Yes. Well, I'm just going to translate the last part. He was saying that you're insulting us by raising our rent. He was asking if you know how much you charge per hour, because he earns per hour.
Because he makes 15.
Hendrik Medrano?
No.
I'm sorry. The previous person was. Oh, I think we mixed. I'm sorry. Just give me 1 second to get this straight. Do we have Ross Tiesha? Ross? Okay. Sorry for the confusion.
Oh, you said Juanita Rodriguez. I'm here.
Okay, you can go, and then Ross. Then Ross. Yes. Thank you, and sorry.
Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.
Yo estoy aquí para dar mi testimonio de los landlords que a través de la ciudad, a través de la HPD, nos dan maltrato a nosotros, porque nosotros, ellos no tienen como que nosotros somos personas de segunda y que nosotros no podemos vivir bien.
So I'm here to give my testimony in regards to landlords across the city and through HPD who are basically treat us like second class citizens and basically don't want us to live well.
Yo también tengo un voucher de sesión 8, la cual hace ya 3 años, del 2017. Creo que ya no tengo sesión 8, la cual la misma sesión 8 me mudó en ese apartamento, un apartamento inservible, y yo les rogué a ellos que me mudaran de nuevo, la cual estaba en el tiempo para ellos mudarme, y ellos no quisieron.
So I have also have a Section 8 voucher. I moved into a Section 8 apartment 3 years ago in 2017. I moved into a basically unlivable apartment, and I asked them to relocate me to a livable apartment well within the amount of time, the 3 months that I was allowed to do that.
El landlord, con Sección 8, ellos supuestamente no cogían dinero de la ciudad, de la HRA. Y fue mentira, la cual cuando la HRA daba un dinero por mi hija que estudiaba, ellos cogían todo el dinero y yo tenía que pagarle la renta, que a toda la renta, aún ellos cogiendo ese dinero. Tengo pruebas en mi casa que se lo puedo mandar.
The landlord would say that HRA would send them no money, but that was a lie. You know, they would, because of my daughter, I would get some credit and I would still have to pay all that money of rent while they still pocketed all the money they got from HRA, and I have proof of all of that in my house.
Ellos cogieron el landlord, el apartamento era con monóxido de carbono, con invasión de rata, con invasión de cucaracha, con los hits que tenía, dos hits defectuosos que llenaban la casa de agua, y la que tuvo que reparar en 5 años, el año pasado, fue la ciudad que tuvo que quitar que los hits no dieran el agua, no rodaran por el piso.
This apartment had a rat infestation, it had a cockroach infestation, it had low heat problems, it would get flooded with water from the radiators, and it was within, it took 5 years for the city to make any repairs.
Cuando van a mi casa, el landlord siempre quiere mandar al super para que el super sea que dé el testimonio de mi casa, de lo que hay en mi casa que no sirve. La cual, la que vivo ahí soy yo, y la que sé lo que no sirve, ahí soy yo. La cuando el súper va, lo que hace es unas reparaciones con cosas que no sirven y las reparaciones vuelven a caerse.
So the landlord will just send the super over so that they can have some sort of itemized testimony of what doesn't work in the house, but I'm the one that has to live with that. I'm the one that knows what doesn't work. And then the super will just do some simple fixer upper things, and you know, whatever he fixes just stops working again later on.
Le permitieron a este landlord que me diera un apartamento de un cuarto de dormir por 2 cuartos de dormir. Le permitieron a este landlord que me robara, que le robara Sección 8, que le robara la HRA, que le robara a todo el mundo, porque la persona que vivía ahí, lo que pagaban eran $900, y me lo rentaron a mí porque tenía Sección 8 y era una señora mayor, me lo rentaron a mí por $1,490.
I had a voucher for a 2-bedroom. They gave me a 1-bedroom. That apartment would go for the person that used to live there would pay $900, and I had to pay.
1,400.
I had to pay $1,490.
Thank you.
Y de ahí en adelante han seguido los harassment conmigo. De todas mis ventanas están llenas de los depósitos de basura de 48 apartamentos. Todas mis ventanas están, la escalera de incendio, todos estábamos en peligro. Hoy fueron a quitarlo dos de los depósitos de basura y los otros como 7 lo dejaron ahí, la cual yo estoy enferma de los pulmones y estoy enferma de diferentes problemas de salud, por la cual que yo estoy inhalando todos esos desperdicios que la basura entra para mi casa.
Thank you.
And the harassment keeps going, even though there's waste deposits around my windows. A fire escape is not working. I'm inhaling all of that waste deposit smell, and it's really hurting my lungs. I'm sick of the lungs right now because of all of this.
Thank you. Our next speaker is Ross Tiesha and Catherine Wilson. Thank you.
Hay muchas cosas que ustedes tienen que saber para por qué este landlord no se merece. Porque si yo hiciera lo que hizo este landlord, yo estuviera en la cárcel. Si nosotros como nosotros hiciéramos eso, nosotros hace años que estuviéramos presos y mal presos. ¿Por qué? Porque ese señor lo que ha hecho es un abuso de poder, un abuso. Tengo el cuarto, la sala mía no tiene gire, La puerta entra toda la basura y todas las cosas porque tiene ¿cómo se dice? Se pone frío porque no tienen hiren. La corte le dio orden de mandar a hacer un hiren ahí, hizo un simulacro de hiren y no. Cuando pasó eso, también hicieron así, me sellaron todas las ventanas, tuvieron que volver a quitarle la grapa que le había puesto. Después,
but you need to know everything that's going on, because if I had done, if any of us here in this room had done what this landlord has done, we would be in jail, we would be in prison, right? Like, we would be very much in prison if we had done what this is, because what he has done is an abuse. You know, I don't have any heat in my home. I don't have anything protecting the door from trash coming in. One time they asked him to fix the heat. He did some sort of fake heat fixing thing, and that didn't work. And one time they even sealed my windows, and when they had to fix that, they had to unseal the things that he had put in the windows to seal them. So you need to know these things.
Thank you. Ross Tiesha? We're going to move on to our next speaker.
Is he translating for her?
Our next speaker, Ross Tiesha.
Terminado, yo no he terminado. Hay muchas cosas las cuales ustedes tienen que saber porque ustedes van a poner la renta alta para nosotros. Esa persona también, cada vez que hace, yo le gané a ellos que me quitaran esa basura de ahí, ellos lo quitaron, pero cuando volvieron y la pusieron, la quitaron en 2016, ahí mismo, en el 2016, en el verano, volvieron y la pusieron, pero la pusieron en la puerta de mi casa. Después, en el baño tampoco, yo no tengo heat en mi casa, yo tengo que poner un radiador eléctrico para yo poder estar. Para yo poder entrar en mi casa, aún tengo también que poner heat eléctrico para toda la casa. No, yo no tengo gas. Yo no tengo gas por 9 meses. También me van a quitar la sesión 8. ¿Te crees una cosa? Con lo poco que yo, del disability que tengo, porque tengo problemas cervicales, lumbares, de toda parte, y tengo los problemas ahora que me puedo hacer casero. Una rata me mordió, las ratas dormían conmigo, en toda parte. Yo tengo todas las fotos.
Thank you.
I want that waste deposit problem. You know, I got that fixed in housing court at one point, and then that was 2016 and 2017. That same waste, they put that not only next to my house, but they put it in front of my door. You know, I have the little money that I make from disability payments, like I have to spend in rent, and I have even more issues with my health now because of the issues in my apartment. A rat bit me because the rat would be around everywhere. I have to have electric heating in my apartment just to exist in my apartment.
Yeah. Have no gas.
Thank you.
I have no gas. Haven't had gas for 9 months.
I have Ross Tiesha, and then I have Catherine Wilson.
Gracias.
Thank you. Gracias. Ross Tiesha.
I just want to make a comment because I think that I don't want it to get lost that a lot of the tenants that are sort of, it sounds repetitive to us as a board, but I just want to highlight that when we make the decision and say only 28% of tenants have preferential rents, some tenants have repairs, not all landlords are bad. This is a story of a combination of tactics that landlords use to displace people. And I don't want that message to get passed, right? She talked about losing her voucher because her landlord refuses to make repairs. She talked about emergency repairs needing to be done by the city because the landlord refuses to make repairs. She talked about the tenant before her paying a lower rent and that rent being almost over doubled. She talked about not having heat, not having gas, and not having quality services in a building that not only the city, I don't know what Section 8 voucher you have, but the city and the federal government are currently paying for substandard conditions. I don't want that message to get lost because when we make our decision, we always talk about data as if it was segmented, and it's not. People are living with multiple issues at the same time, and I don't want that to get lost.
I have Ross Tiesha, and I have Catherine Wilson. Is Catherine Wilson there? Here? I think so.
Where did she come?
I have Maria Hernandez.
Catherine Wilson is here. She's right there.
Okay.
Wait.
Catherine Wilson's right there.
Do I have Catherine? Catherine
right
Wilson?
There. Right there.
Catherine, you want to come up to the mic?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Hello, I'm glad that I'm here today to give this testimony. I live at 1380 University Avenue. My landlord got $46 million, 30-year tax credit write-off. File builder. We got it renovated. It's garbage. I mean, the things that he put in there, breaking up, it's horrible. When I moved out of my apartment, I had a leak over my bathroom tub. I moved back. That leak is still there. They act like they can't find it, but he said he was going to put new pipes in it. So the $46 million, I guess, just didn't have enough. He pulled up our parquet floors, put down tile floors that keep cracking. My super just fixed them. I'm thinking about mine's got fixed for the third time. He's going to come and fix two tomorrow that broke again. I'm saying that when the landlord says that they're going to do something and we give them money to do it, they should be able to do this right and do it correct. Not all landlords are bad, but we do have bad apples floating. And when a landlord is so greedy, and my landlord has a lot of buildings, and Vanessa Gibson was here and she gave testimony, but she was there because we signed this agreement in city council. So a lot of things that we think is going to happen ain't happened. When we had renovation, HPD did not come back out and inspect our building. So everything that's done is done in garbage. $46 million and every weekend one of our elevators is out. He was supposed to put a new elevator in it. All he did was renovate it. I mean, when y'all look at these here landlords and y'all just see us up here talking and giving testimony, and I'm not going to say where y'all live because I don't care where y'all live at. I know where I live at. All I want to say is where we live at, we're giving testimony and we really, really need that help. I don't want to pay no more rent. My landlord took me to court. I just got out of court May. For 8 months we was in court. I didn't owe him a dime. Not one dime. Come to find out, he owes me money. Isn't that something? How
thank
could
you.
That be? Now, you saying thank you, but I said thank you to the judge who told me to get a lawyer. That's some craziness. I'm asking y'all the same way. Help us, because we definitely need help in New York City. And
thank
you know
you.
What? The Bronx ain't going nowhere.
Thank you.